You have defied Newton's laws.
Why should I care about the laws some washed-up bum made? He was old news back in 1727.
When he died.
Rest in peace, Sir Isaac.
So what did Sir Isaac Newton do?
Well...
An object that isn't moving will have an acceleration of 0 meters per second squared. It has a velocity of 0 and will have a velocity of 0 until someone or something makes it move. Example, if you throw a ball, you made it accelerate to its current speed. It won't move without you or any other type of interaction from anyone or anything else. After throwing the ball, you'll notice that it moves downwards, even if you throw it upwards. Well, my friend, you live on Earth, and unfortunately, Earth isn't a vacuum. We have to deal with air resistance, gravity, and any other variables that decide to stink up our experiments. If it wasn't for air resistance or gravity, the ball would continue to fly indefinitely. It is an object in motion that will remain in motion unless acted upon by an outside force. Since we are on Earth, the ball will always have an acceleration of 9.8 meters per second squared downwards, and the air will do as it pleases. It's living its life. This one's really just common sense with a formula attached to it. As we all know, if you apply a force, like a push, to an object, it moves. Now we build upon that. If you push that same object harder, it has a higher acceleration. More force equals more acceleration. But what happens when you try to push a heavier object? The object doesn't go as far anymore.
Hey, Oliver.
Is that 3 newtons of force?
Yes.
We can make a formula for this. Acceleration equals force over mass. An object's acceleration is equal to the force being applied to it divided by the mass of the object. This equation can be rearranged to find the force applied to an object. Force equals mass times acceleration. The force being applied to an object is equal to the object's mass multiplied by its acceleration. If that sounds complicated to you, think of it like this. That force wasn't as powerful as... A force is a push or pull that acts upon an object. It is caused by an interaction involving contact, and for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. Think about this. When you go to sit on a chair, your body exerts a force against the chair. So, how do you stay on the chair? The chair is exerting a force to your body that is equal to your mass. Both forces are equal. Here's another example. If you kick off a skateboard, your foot pushes against the ground, and in turn, the ground pushes against your foot, letting you roll. Regardless, the law works. They all do. Until they don't!
So what are quantum mechanics?
Beats me!
Okay, the video isn't over yet, but I honestly don't know anything about quantum mechanics, so this is going to be a very short overview. Just understand that Newton's laws don't always work, such as with very small atoms or black holes, which, honestly, black holes defy every law known to man, including adultery. Even though Newton's laws don't always work, they still make for a great general guideline in real life. Just ignore quantum mechanics and you'll be good.
They also don't work when you're making a shooting stars meme.